Good morning, everybody. Happy Thanksgiving. I hope everybody is enjoying their day. I just wanted to come on. I'm not going to make a very long video, I hope, I think, I don't know. I'm going to attempt a few things. First of all, I want to say Happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there. Stay warm, stay dry, stay with family, stay connected, and be grateful. And then I also wanted to tell you I'll be filming more over the weekend and get all caught up, I hope. I always say that, but never do. And then I wanted to make a special announcement or two or three. This, what's in this package, I promised to do a toast to Melissa Sue about. This is the craziest thing, and I tell you, you're going to want to go to her channel just to see what's out there, right? Because if it's new and it's reviewable, you're going to find it on her channel. And she'll give you a heads up. Hey, don't buy this, do that. Okay, so Melissa Sue. And I'll leave a link to her channel in my description box. Okay, so check this out, right? This is an extra large glue stick. So toast out there, Melissa Sue. Honest to God, I believe only you could find these things. Now, this is made by Doris. I haven't used it yet, but I have on her word that it works good. I was going to show you. They're saying this is the equivalent to either 8 or 18 glue sticks. Right? I don't know, but it's 115 grams. It's a 4-ounce glue stick. Look at this. Now, what I use mine for, and I have some larger ones, not this large. Let me see if I can find what I'm looking for. You guys hold the beautiful view of this ginormous glue stick. It's just insane. But I got it, like I said, just because. Here's a regular glue stick. Show you a regular glue stick. I have the ones that come from the Dollar Tree. They're this size. And then I actually think this one might be a little. This one's 0.28 ounces. This one's 0.32 ounces. Actually, believe it or not, this one's larger. It must be the lid that throws it off. Okay, so I get this one, the blue one, from the Dollar Tree. I get the Scotch Permanent from Amazon, and then I got this one from Amazon, but you can definitely see the difference there. It's just mind-boggling. Here we go. I found it. I know it wasn't far. This is the larger one that I get from the Dollar Tree. So even this one was okay, but this one, it's not that great of a glue stick. This is good for temporary jobs that you want to go back in and sew on. Okay, this guy I'll use here in just a bit. And as soon as I get my ink out of the trash can, I'll tell you what's up next. Okay, so what's up next is the mixing of alcohol inks. And I went to the Dollar Tree and I got the spray bottles. And I've got some oxide inks that later on I'm going to dispose of, and then I'm going to wash and dry the bottles and put alcohol ink in them. Now, how do I know these are going to, well, I don't know what we're going to do. We're just going to mix, because I like to add the sprays, right? Mixed media. And so I spray a lot of it. I'm not going to put a whole lot in here until I know for sure I like the color. Okay, so I have this butterscotch that I do like. We're going to mix this. That should be enough. Let's see what color we get. And then we're going to test it on watercolor paper. watercolor paper. And then I'll keep these for collages if they if I like how they look, right? I should probably put well, I can see some of it already right there. What I like about the alcohol ink is how quickly it dries. Okay, whoops. Back down. Okay, this is butterscotch. Not bad. I like that one. Okay, next up is going to be. Oh, I had another open bottle here. Oh, I did. That's a nice color. All right, so I want to try. There was one, not eggplant. Paprika. I want to try the paprika. And this is special formula ink. So I don't know how it's going to behave, but we're going to find out. At some point this week, this weekend, like Saturday, I think I'm going to be mass producing. Let's try the paprika. See what we get. Ooh, it's pretty. Looks good to me. I like that color. And I should be labeling these. I will make a label here before I get too far gone. I'll do swatches actually and labels. Ooh, y'all, look at that. I like that. Okay, so before we get too far gone, I gotta do labels, you guys. Even if they're makeshift. Or I will be so screwed up. Okay, butterscotch. So hopefully everybody's doing great, enjoying your holiday. I know I'm feeling pretty special because I'm off until after. I don't go back to work till December 4th. So I'm pretty excited. However, not too, I'm trying to get this off, guys. Not too happy about a dental procedure I have to have. Okay, so now I know that's butterscotch. And the next one was paprika. Yeah, I like that one. It's kind of a pink, but it's okay. It's gonna look good with some of the stuff I'm gonna do. Paprika reminds me of the cartoons or the little kids show my kids used to watch. And I was telling my friend this hilarious story, okay? I don't want to get copyrighted, so I'm just going to drop enough hints. I think all of us with a child under the age of 30 will remember it had a big bear. And there was the There was a moon they called the moon Luna. And when the show started, the bear would come out and, have something to say. And he would get the kids, he would tell the kids to come closer, right, to the TV. And this one particular day, my two oldest boys. Happy Thanksgiving, Michael and Andrew. My two oldest boys watch this show every morning, right? Well, I got them ready and fed them breakfast because I was a single working mom. Got them ready to go, got everything, and I put them in front of the TV to watch the show so I could finish getting ready. And they had had pancakes that morning, right? And so here comes the bear, and he's like, he's got his nose up, close to the camera, and he's sniffing. And he tells, any child or adult watching it, come a little closer, come a little closer. And he says, I smell pancakes. And my two boys lost their mind. They were totally like traumatized. Oh my God, Mom, he knows what we had for breakfast. And they were freaking freaking out, and I could not get them to watch that show ever, ever, never again. That was that. That was done. It was over. Okay, so I should have, you know what I should have done? God, you guys. I should have done this. We'll get it to tear out. Butterscotch. Then I know what it looks like on the paper. The next up was paprika. Let that dry. And next up, we're gonna try squash. And I got a feeling it's gonna be real close to butterscotch for some reason. Let's try it. And then there's a teal. Ooh, it's pretty. It's pretty. So at least it's pretty in the bottle. Lid, there we go. Okay, here we go. Shake, shake, shake. This is squash. Let me write paprika. This is squash. Let's see how squash looks. It's kind of a yellow. Let it dry. So that's what we're gonna do, well, I'm gonna do, as you guys watch. And oh, I got the acrylic paints too, and there was something else I wanted to try. I think if you water down acrylic paint, it's basically gonna be the same thing, right? I really do. I don't think there's going to be any difference. Squash. Okay. So I'll try that. Maybe not in this video, but in the next one. All right. So these are the inks. They're not the alcohol. No, these are special inks. I don't know what's special about them, but they're special inks. All right. Next up, we're going to try. That's Dijon. I already did some yellows. Let's try the teal. Taken with teal. See what we get. And I'm going to get all of these done today or tomorrow. And then I'm going to do some mixed media stuff with them. Kind of got a feeling I'm going to like the teal, so make a little more. And I know going forward, I won't get the same color every single time. It's going to change up. It'll be lighter or darker. So, got to keep that in mind as I'm working on projects. Boy, that one went light, didn't it? I might need some more for this one. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that one went way light. It's almost like I bleached it. Let's put some more in here of the teal. Might do it. That just might do it. Very light still. Very super, super light. I wanted the teal to be a good color. And I want to use it up before it goes bad on me. You know, dries up, hardens, because they do. See, you can barely see that that was even there. Test drive it. Oh, much better. Yeah, teal. Let's see what we get next. Let me mark this one. It says taken with peel, but trust me, I'm not gonna put that big of a. I'm not gonna put it on that. It won't matter to me. It's just gonna be teal. This is gonna be cool because I'm gonna do some book pages and some stamping and. Next up will be what? I got. Let's try turquoise. And then we'll go on to the colors we're pretty used to seeing. Turquoise. I just saw turquoise. I just saw turquoise. Here it is. Okay, let's fill it up. Turquoise is pretty too. Turquoise is pretty as well. I really like that paprika. Oops. Look at that turquoise. That's pretty. Yup. I think I need to turn this light off. Sorry, guys. Yeah, that's a lot prettier. I'm in the dark here. I can't tell you why. I don't know if it's cloudy outside or not. Goodness gracious, I don't know. Might have been better off leaving it on. Seems dark in here today. Okay, all right, moving on. Let's try. I don't know if I want to try lettuce, ginger, Dijon, caramel. Let's try a middle one. Let's try copper. Shake it up real good. Let's try copper before I end the video. We'll try copper because, like I said, I'm going to do some mixed media here in a bit. And it's basically trying to get my fall colors out because I'm going to finish up one of my, well, maybe two of my. Well, I don't know, one or two, hopefully three fall journals. Ooh, this does not want to come out. I wonder if it's not opened. I bet you it's not opened yet. Some of these were brand new, some of these were used in the. Lot that I won on eBay. So we'll try to open it up. Ooh. No. Seems like it was okay. There we go. I may not have shaken it enough, guys. Seems like it's pretty clogged up. Like, you can hear it. Shake it again. Whoops, went on the paper, all right. Well, we'll have to do it the slow way here, like freaking milking a cow, man. Right, we're gonna go with that, see how it looks. I don't have the patience, you all. I just don't. Pretty on the paper just like that. Okay. Not getting anything. Yeah, I think it just kind of diluted. It's got shimmer. That's about it. Interesting. I don't want to waste, you know. I don't want to waste it. Anyhow, I'm going to end the. Try to get a little more of this in there. I want to see how it looks. Oh, there we go. I got a good one on that one. Oops, nothing on that one. Wonder what that big ol'. If that's a good thing or a bad thing. Clogged up. I don't know. I'm not gonna mess with this one a whole lot. I'll add another color to it and wish for the best. Well, you do get sparkles. See? But you really gotta spray it. Well, I'm not exactly impressed with that. See? Yeah, I can live without the copper. We'll figure out something else to do with that. And I don't know if I'll keep this or not because you really gotta spray like a lot. Right, let's flip it over and move along here. Copper is a no-go. Right, so I'm not even gonna do any more of the metals. I'll figure out something else to do with them. But what I did wanna do is try one acrylic ink or one acrylic paint mix, and then we'll move on. Let me see what I got here that might be kind of cool. Liquor white, I don't want. Let's go with light mocha. Oh, I gotta water it down, don't I? Yes, I do. I don't know if I have water. I do not, guys. Oh, yes, I do. I do have water. Fill up my, not fill it up, but get some, get enough in this bottle to water it down. Put a drop. Okay, that should work. My biggest and worst fear is that it's going to be clogging this, but you know, it's a Dollar Tree bottle. Looks kind of cool. Well, look at that. Yeah, I like that. Okay. I gotta mark that one in acrylic paint and move it out of the way, but I can live with that. It's actually kind of cool. Well, how do you like that? See, I like to coffee dye and stain my paper, but I'm not a fan of how watercolor feels on a paper. So if I want to create something in watercolor and then scan it, then that I feel okay about it, but look at that. Well, it appears to me that I'm gonna go broke at the Dollar Tree buying these spray bottles. All right, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.